Hi and hello all, welcome you all for the beginner's mentor. Let's jump into the Linux system to understand them. So first open your terminal and type cd /bin. Once you are inside the /bin directory, list out the contents of the directory by typing the command ls. We have got a bunch of directories and the folders in front of us. These are all the executable files, or we can say them as binary files, or the programs and the applications we run in our system. For example, we take the ls command that we use to list out the files or the folders which are available in inside a folder or a directory. Right here you can see the ls program or the application which we run in our system presently. And then let's go back to the root directory and type in, to go back to this root directory, we have to type cd.dot. This will make you to go back to the root directory again. List out the contents. There we have to see the next folder as /dev. So we have to type the command as cd/dev. So this will give me as make me inside the /dev directory. List out the files. Once we list out the files, we can see these are all the files which may have the list of devices like pen drive or webcam connected to our system. We can see the SDA where my hard disk has been divided into several other drives. Can you see this SDA, SDA1, SDA2, SDA5? So these are all the directories or the drives which my hard disk has been partitioned into. Whatever be the new device connected, that will be automatically listed here. The next directory which we can see here is, go back to the root directory and cd. So list the home here. We have the only one folder called Menta. Here the folder which the user's personal directory or the files will be listed here. So here do we have the user called Menta, and the Menta's files and personal things or personal folders will be listed out inside the Menta. Recently, we don't have anything inside the Menta. So you can see here, nothing is inside. So let's go back and let's clear the screen. /media folder, cd/media. So list out, we have CD-ROM and CD-ROM 0. So when you plug in any USB or any other storage devices, which will be stored or which will be listed here as we get to know, as we get to connect them with our machine. We have another directory called /mount/mnt, that is a /mount directory, where the partition device may get mount whenever the user feels it needed. Let me go back to the root directory and go to mnt mount, list it out. We don't have anything presently mounted there. Yeah, presently in my computer we don't have anything which is mounted or which is unmounted in my system. Our folder is empty now. So let's clear the screen and go back to the root directory again. Then now the next directory I need to take up is /opt, where the software we compile will get landed up here. /opt, list out the softwares which we compile. Presently we don't have anything, right? Presently I didn't have installed any software presently, the new software. When you run the burp suit, I think it may list it up here. Other applications like burp suit or voice shock will land up in the opt/bin directory, and the libraries are will be listed in this opt/library directory. Yeah, here we have, let me go back to the root directory again. CD root, list it out. We have CD or give a tab to fulfill the name. We have two directories which starts with the name called root and run. Presently we have to choose the next word as root. So again tab, this will make you up into root directory. List out. Here we have the contents of the root, that is the super users, personal devices, personal directories, personal folders will be listed out here. So here we can take up the files and directories of the root user. Clear the screen Let me go back to the next folder or the directory, which I would like to show you is slash sys. So cd slash sys. So we have some informal words that also slash sys is the virtual directory that all that contains informations from devices connected to your computer. To manipulate them or to do changes with this, we need to be a super user. Go back slash sbin cd slash sbin. Clear them. Cd slash sbin. Disturb them. Here you will be having a bunch of binary files. Again here, this is super user binary files. To access them or to run them in your terminal, you need to be the super users. So it may be called as a super user binary files. To manipulate or to do changes with them, you need to be mandatorily, you need to be the super user. Sbin can also be abbreviated as the system binary folder. So whoever not being the user or so root user have to give the sudo command to uplift their privileges to run this. Next in the line, let's see the user directory cd slash user. That means let me go back and clear the screen first. Cd slash user. The user directory contains the mishmash of the directories, which in turn contains the applications, libraries, documents, wallpapers, icons, and a long list of other stuffs that need to be shared by the applications and services. So these are all the wallpapers, our library files, documentations, icons. What are all the stuffs that can be that need to be shared by the applications and services to be inside of the user's bin? So let me go back and again let me open the directory, change the directory to the slash srb. Let me check. We have seen bin, we have seen dev, we have seen home, we have seen media, we have seen opt. I think we haven't seen opt. We have seen sys, we have seen user. Now we have to see the srb directory. So cd is and give a tab. There's a list of the file names which starts with yes. You have to select the file name which you have to run. So give the next character of your file name as R and give the tab. Enter. You will be inside of the SRB folder. List them out. You have the TFTP server which is running there. So let me explore this SRB slash SRB directory that contains the server data. If you are running a web server from your Linux box, your HTML files for your sites would go into slash srv slash http. If you were using or running in your FTP server in your system, the user files or your files will go to slash srv slash ftp. Now in my system, the server I run is tftp. So here we can see slash srv slash tftp listed out there. So let me go back and change my directory to boot folder. So the files, the boot directory has the very, very important files which we need to run while the system gets started up. The files in the directory are the files which pushes the OS to run in your system properly. You can see the config file. You can see the grub folder there. You can see the init already file and system map vm linux files are. And it's a caution to you all, if you mess up with these files, you will be getting a struggle to get up your system again. So in our YouTube channel stuff, you might have seen a video of grub folder. In our YouTube channel itself, you might have gone through a video which is fixing the grub rescue error. So what might have happened there is they might have deleted the grub folder which is located here, or the files inside the grub folder, they might have replaced the files inside the grub folder They might have done something or they might have messed up something inside the slash boot folder. So only they are facing these kind of problems there. And let me go back. Hey guys, do you know where are important files that contain the name of our system, the users and the passwords are stored in? Yeah, obviously that is stored in your etc. etc can be abbreviated as etc. And presently this etc contains the most of all system-wide configuration files. For example, the names of machines on your network, when and where the partitions on your hard disks should be mounted are all in here. Can you see these configuration files? These are system-wide configuration files. You can see here .conf, here also .conf, here also .conf. This means that there are configuration files which are listed in your system. And where our passwords and usernames are stored, that is your homework to find them. Okay. It is easy to find out from this bunch of files. If you are interested, please try it by yourself and find them. They are in front of you. So let me go back and let me clear the screen first. Oh, sorry, I forgot to zoom in. The code that your applications use are live in the library folder. Fine. The code that your application uses are live in the library folder. So when you go into the library folder and list them, you will be getting this bunch of files. Again, these are all the codes which your applications are use have been stored in your library folder. The applications that you use to draw the windows on your desktop, the control peripherals, or it can send your files to your hard disk also. We have the virtual directory in our file system. Let me go back and show the virtual directory which lives in our file system. cd/proc. This is our virtual directory. Let me show the what are the files inside. You can be it might be a Greek to you all that you can't by find any names which is familiar to you. But this is a virtual directory. This contains the information about your computer, such as the information about your CPU and the kernel on your Linux system, which is running on. Clear this screen. And let me go back to the root again, cd.out, and list out. Let us check what we have to see next. We have seen slash bin, we have seen slash etc, we have seen media, we have seen proc, we have wint seen sbin, we have to see temp, we have to see boot, we have seen boot, we have seen home, we have seen library, we have seen mount, have we seen the root? I think we have. Oh, no problem, let's find it again. We have seen user, we have seen sys, we have seen dev. Now we have to see the slash run. Yeah, that is here. So let me go and give a name or give a tab. You will be listed out with the file names and you have to give run. And here you are, list of the contents. So to store the temporary data in our system, we have the run folder or directory where the system processes are run, and we use the slash run folder to store the temporary data for the system's own reason. And let me go back, clear the screen first and list out the files. Now presently we have to go with temp folder, which is somewhat similar with the run folder which we have seen. Give a tab, we have got in list out, we have seen system uses the slash temp to use store the temporary files. Slash temp is one of the few directories which is hanging off or the directory or that you can actually interact with without being the super user. So in order to interact with the slash temp folder or slash temp directory, you need not to become the super user. And let's look up to the directory where we do have the data which we do cd slash var. Sorry, var. Presently, we are inside of the var directory, and we have some list of directory, list of files or folders which is displayed in front of us. That is backups, cache, library, local, lock, log, mail, apt run, mail, apt run, spool, temp, www. So www may have the all HTML things where we can run the server, I think so. So let me say you, slash where was originally named, which has given its name because the contents were deemed variable, because they change frequently. There are many other directories that also contain the data that changes frequently, especially the virtual directories that already we have saw above as proc, dev. They are also the virtual directories, their data may change frequently. Be that as it may, slash where for directory contains the things like logs in the war, things like logs into the var directory. Logs registers whatever the events which happens in your system. If something fails in kernel, it will be logged in a file in slash var slash log. If someone tries to break into your computer from outside, your firewall will also log that attempt into that var log folder. It also contains spools for tasks. These tasks can be the jobs you send to a shared printer when you have to wait because the another user is printing a long document, or the mail which has to be printed out before you. So in order to, while you are waiting, that event has been logged into this slashware directory. So as far as now, we have been listen the file system here. We have slash bin, which we have discussed. We have etc, we have discussed. We have slash media that we have discussed. We have slash proc, we have discussed. We have sbin that we have discussed. We have temp, we have discussed them. And we have boot, home, library, amount, root, sov, user, dev, and opt, run, sys, var. Finally, we have discussed all of them. And please, you don't dig too deep about this. These are all the file systems which are available in your Linux. You need to know about them, where you have to keep your hands, where you should not touch even. That's it. For that concern only, I have given you a brief video about what are all the things which Linux file system has. So this is it all for today's video. Thank you. Thank you for watching, beginners and